Right. I have done well. But I want to say that this party called APGA was the party we founded from the scratch to fill the gap the Igbos have always had in the political arena in Nigeria. Chepa Sokolie, my friend at that time, and still my brother today, because I'm sure with time he will tell a different story from what he has been telling all along. Because of politics, he tried to misrepresent the facts, because he was fighting for survival. He was a man I worked very closely to get this party registered. Mike and Ebu, he was involved from day one. Okoye is a bosom friend. Yes. So he knows the story. We set out to create a very good identity in the political arena for Igbo people and give them a platform where they can fight for their rights in Nigeria. Unfortunately, because the election came and things didn't go the way we expected, the election was rigged. APGA mandate was stolen all over the Southeast. That opened another line of action for us, litigation. So we went to court. It was while we were in court here in Anambra State trying to recover our mandate that was freely given to APGA through P2B that the devil crept into the ranks of APGA. I was the PW1 in that election petition. I tendered all the results sheets for the gubernatorial election and went through a battery of cross-examinations from 6 senior advocates, 3 on the side of Mugige, 2 from INEC, and 1 from PDP. So it was a long-fought battle, and because it had become obvious, you were there at the tribunal here in Oka. So I'm sure most of you, get money for all of them were covering it. Even though at that time they didn't want us to win. So we were working very hard. And when it became clear to all and sundry that APGA was on course to reclaiming that mandate, the devil came into APGA and tried to divide our ranks. That's what caused the disagreement between us and our pioneer chairman. So it was a personal quarrel between me and him, and it wasn't out of personal ambition for me to be chairman. I had to step in to galvanize the remaining efforts to ensure that that mandate was recovered. And I thank God that on the 5th of August, 12th of August 2005, the tribunal proclaimed Peter Obi and APGA winner of the governorship election. We went through the Court of Appeal in Enugu and won again on 15th of March 2006, paving the way for Obi and APGA to have a first governor's warning on 17th March here in Oka in 2006. That's the beginning of the journey, and that's how all things changed. The struggle that followed wasn't easy either. The PDP that was very strong and eased them off power here wanted to get us out of power immediately. Obi was unconstitutionally impeached. We had to go through the courts to get the impeachment set aside. The House of Assembly went to the Court of Appeal in Enugu, and the Court of Appeal dismissed the appeal. And we did all that we can do as patriotic leaders. The Lieutenant Governor of Blessed Memory, with me coordinating the affairs, we were able to get to be reinstated on the 9th of February 2007. That was it. And when they said it, Obi was a youth corps governor, I said he cannot be a youth corps governor. I went to the Constitution and saw that section 180, subsection 2, clearly spells out the tenure of office of a governor. The tenure of office of a governor shall be for 4 years, starting from the day he takes oath of office. So the clamor was that Obi was on his way out. And I said, we are going to challenge it in court to interpret the constitution. I was one who granted an interview that was published in August 2006 to the effect that Obi would be in office till 2010. I did. It was probably the person who interviewed me was Stanley Okeke of their son newspapers. And this interview was published. When they went and read my interview, it's part of a chain of actions. That was also one of the reasons why he was impeached, so that he must stay to see that happen. But we had to go through, when they conducted the election, we had gone into the courts to interpret that section of the Constitution. We told them not to conduct the election. They defied it. They conducted the election. And one of our brothers was sworn in on 29th of May 2007. By then we had been at the Supreme Court. It wasn't easy because we lost at the Federal High Court. We lost at the Court of Appeal. And they tried to prevent us from getting to the Supreme Court before 29th of May. I was the one who wrestled them down at the Court of Appeal in Enugu and ensured that we moved the record of appeal to the Supreme Court within 48 hours. Yes. And by 28th of May 2007, we were already before the Supreme Court. We sought for an injunction restraining anybody from swearing in the person they declared winner. The Supreme Court said they had taken the matter and there was no need given an injunction. If we come back on the 14th of June, if an appeal was found to be meritorious, that the person, even if the person is sworn in or not, the person will back it. So we retired to the hotel, myself and my brother Peter. We prayed. And in the morning, he left for London and wished me good luck. I should continue. So I said, go, let's wait. It was a fierce battle, but on the 14th of June, he came into London, joined me in Abuja. I was in court, he was in the hotel waiting. And one is Mr. John Boone from Enugu State was dispatched from the police headquarters, Abuja, to arrest me immediately after the judgment. But I had written a petition against me. But when we were there, I knew that God would answer our prayer. Amen. And it didn't take time. The Supreme Court rose for 20 minutes after the briefs were adopted, came back and said that they have had a deep look at that simple position in the Constitution, that Obi tenure will run for 4 years. That they should back, the person who is there should immediately vacate so that Obi would complete his tenure. You know. When I was coming out, two policemen came, those who were detailed to carry me, Inspector John Boone from Enugu State. I don't know who knows him here. And I said, what is the business? He said, they said I should be there. I said, please, don't spoil my joy. So we are celebrating, you know. I said, okay, let's go to my party secretary. From there, we'll go to police. And by the time I got to the secretariat, I got my lawyer, Ikweto, to follow me to the police headquarters. When we got there, a commissioner of police, CP Mike Zuakumo from Bayelsa of Rivers, he was waiting, he was the CP in charge. When I came in, they were watching the news, Supreme Court news on television. As soon as we got there and my name was sent in, he said, bring him in. When I came in, the man said, hey, you are tough. So if we won this case, I said, yes, we won. The arrangement was that we will lose the case and from there we'll go to prison. Yeah. So we won, and that victory discharged me of the offense. That is it. So you can see how happy I am that from a very turbulent beginning, we have come to the point where I can now win an award as Man of the Year 2017. I've won awards before, several indeed. But I cherish this one because I think it's an expression of acknowledgement of what I'm able to do. Let me tell you that everything I have done in my political journey had always been for the good of the Igbo people, for the good of democracy, and for the good of the people of Anambra State. But when I intervened here, this place was on the ground. We had to use Abel to bring Anambra State from the doldrums, starting with Peter Obi, who did well in 8 years in governing the state. And Obiano came, now the current governor. He's done 4 years, he's on a second leg, and he has done very well. He has improved, on what Peter did. And Anambra State is moving to the enviable height of one of the best states in Nigeria. So this is what Abga has done. And I feel very proud to be associated with this success. So, there are so many other things.